back. We've got some cool gear here in the studio. Well, more like a, well, you wouldn't call it a machine, but this is killer right here. First off, Koski Snow Sports, Don Koski, Jeff Butcher, and they brought in one of the more premium snow bikes I've ever seen. So give us your background, because you're sort of the inventor on this, and a little bit of history and the concept.
Okay, well, when I was a kid, we used to ski at Mount Rose, and I was about 6 years old, and we saw the lift operators riding what they called ski bumps back then. And then we quit skiing for quite a few years and opened up a bike shop in 1970, and I knew how to weld through high school and stuff, and kind of got the bug again and did some research in Europe, talked to all the embassies and Italy, France, and Germany, got a bunch of literature, saw what they were building, and so I thought I'd build a better mousetrap and built the first prototype in 1970. Rode it once, that was just rear suspension and foot pegs, and then all the other bikes from then on were full suspension foot pegs, and kind of brought motocross into, as far as motocross suspension, long seats, comfort, easy to ride, and so then brought us here today, and we helped develop the mountain bike movement back in the early 70s. And
we see these snow bikes, and I've never seen a seat like this on it. Yeah. You said you have a motocross background as well?
Yeah, we rode motocross as kids.
It's a bit of a hybrid in a way.
Yeah, you ride it more like a motocross bike than than skis. You steer with the front, slide with the back, so you're fully controlled by setting up your turns ahead of time. When you hit the bumps, you stand on the pegs, or if you're just hitting small mobiles and stuff, you sit on the seat. We have 9 inches of travel in the back, 8 1/4 in the front, so it's a real cushy, comfortable ride. That big seat allows you to move around,
right?
Because you can use your body weight, to handle the bike.
Yeah, what kind of travel does this suspension have?
We have 9 inches in the back, and then 8 1/4 in the front, and both front and rear are fully adjustable. You can change the spring rate, the hydraulics, the dampening, compression and rebound, so you can taper the suspension to the rider's needs and the terrain.
Can you swap out the skis as well? Are those
transferable? Yeah, these are 99 centimeters right here. You can go anywhere. I use 113s on mine. We're developing new fat skis for powder usage, so you get more flotation.
Have you rode one of these in the powder?
I have, and it is a blast.
I bet.
And one thing that we did with this new bike is the pegs are adjustable, so you can swing the pegs back according to the conditions. So that way, you unload the front end.
It's like snowboard. Put a little back on the back leg and get the nose up.
The center of gravity comes back. You sit on the tail of the bike, and it floats on top of the powder.
That's so, gotta be an awesome feeling. And Jeff, what's your role with Koski Snowsport?
Well, I got back in 1971. I saw these, not the Koskis, but the old bikes over at Homewood. So I got on that. I used to be a skier. I haven't gone back since. I've been riding since 1971. Since then, I've hooked up with Don. It must have been, 17 years ago.
I
got on his bike, and I said, this is where it was at. So I've been doing it recreationally. I've taken a couple medals in competition in Colorado, held a couple titles in Oregon, Hoodoo Mountain. So I compete for fun, and the ski bike festivals are great. They're a lot of fun. Everybody comes from around the world and the nation.
It seems like a sort of a niche community, but you guys are looking to expand it and make it more widespread.
Yeah.
What do you see for the future in this sport?
Well, we'd like to get events, get some races going, but the main thing is we want to get the people that don't want to ski or can't ski or snowboard to get them on the mountain, show them there's a different avenue to approach the ski industry. It's a whole different market. You have the people that have never skied, maybe too frail, a little beat up, bad back, bad knees. The younger crowd that maybe wants to get into them, maybe the X Game type stuff, because these things, my top riders are clearing the doubles at Heavenly, getting 70 feet of air, 15 to 20 feet.
In the high roller?
Yeah. They're clearing them.
Wow,
but
I want to see that.
They're so comfortable, and the learning curve is 15 minutes. If you can ride a bicycle, you can get on these things immediately.
What about getting on the chairlifts? Can you take this one right here, show up with an average lift ticket, and hop on a chairlift? legally, or, you know, with
depending on the ski resort, all the old resorts are open to ski biking.
Okay.
Tahoe Basin, you have, so you have Heavenly, Sierra Tahoe, North Star, and it's the sports expanding, and what we do is we go out and talk to lift management, lift ops people, to show them how safe they are. The main thing is safety. It's like anything. We're breaking new ground, even though ski bikes have been around for 60 years. You have to show how safe they can be, and possible another lift ticket sold, and just get more people right on the mountain.
All right, we got to wrap this up here, but for the ski bike enthusiasts out there that are just getting this, are there any competitions in the basin that you would recommend looking into?
Not yet. We're trying to work with
John. So that's
John
why you're here. Just
yeah.
With John Rice?
John Rice
is
here at Tahoe.
Awesome.
He invited
us
to do some events this year, and hopefully we get everything together and have some fun.
All right. Thanks, guys. Don Koski, Jeff Butcher, Koski Snow Sports here. Look them up online and get on one of these bikes. It's really easy, and you can do it at any Vail resort. So we'll be back with more Tahoe today right after this break.